The Beamer package is used to make presentation slides. It's actually a special type of document class, so we'll need to replace article with Beamer in the document class declaration in the preamble. You will still need to create a document structure and put your presentation inside of it. The basic structure of a Beamer document is the frame environment. A frame may consist of one or more slides. We'll see how one frame leads to many slides later. We'll start with a basic frame with just a little bit of text. Once you have your frame, you can create a frame title. This is text that will appear at the top of all the slides in your frame. You might notice that the bottom right corner has some symbols. These are navigation symbols that you can use to move forward and backwards through your slide deck. If you want to get rid of that, put Beamer template navigation symbols empty in the preamble. Everything else that you'd want to put into your slide can be done in the same way you would put it into an article. The text that you type will appear in the slide. You can also have equations, itemized and enumerated lists, tables, imported graphics, and ticks images. If you wanted to have multiple columns of text on your slide, you can use the columns environment. To start each column, you will need to make a column declaration and specify the width of the column. It usually makes sense to define this width relative to the line width. For example, if you want to make two columns, you can choose to have your column widths be half of a line width, but you can define those widths to be whatever you want. The environment will automatically create a bit of padding so that there's a space between the columns and balance the spacing horizontally. Technically, that bit of padding will make it so that if you have two columns at half a line width, the edges of the text will be slightly outside the standard page width. We'll come back to that in a moment. Notice that the column environment will also vertically center each column. It does not matter whether one column is longer than the other, each one will be vertically centered. You can also put text above and below the columns if you wanted. You may want to use VSpace to create a little bit of vertical padding. You can also see the artifact of the padding between the columns. If it bothers you that the columns make that area wide, you can shrink the widths of your columns down to about 0.45 line width, and that should fix things. Since this is a presentation package, there are a few more things we can do to enhance the presentation. One frame can be turned into multiple slides by having different parts appear and disappear at different times, as well as making formatting changes as you go through the slides. The most basic tool for this is the pause command. This will display everything in the frame up to the command on one slide, and then create a second slide immediately afterwards that has the full contents. You can actually have multiple pauses and create many slides with a single frame. A more sophisticated tool is the use of specification overlays. These are values inside pointing brackets that indicate the slides within the frame that you want things to appear. A number by itself means that you want that feature on a single frame. A range of values means all the frames, including the endpoints. A number followed by a dash means all the frames, starting from the frame number and onwards. And you can use multiple instructions separated by commas. The most common place for this is in an itemized environment. With the specification overlays, we can make the bullet points appear and disappear in any order we choose. Notice that the positions of the bullet points are preserved so that they do not shift up or down as we move through the slides. We can also apply this to other text. We can use it to control when certain words are put in bold or italicized font, or change the color of the text. These can be used to emphasize certain words at certain moments on the slide. There are also two ways we can make text appear on the slide. We can uncover text that was there the whole time, or we can make text appear only on certain slides. Notice the unusual spacing on the only parameter. The reason for this is that if you put space outside the brackets, you will get a double space when the text is absent. Another structure that's useful for presentations are blocks. Blocks are a special formatting where you have a title and then text. It may not look like much now, but when we start applying themes, the blocks will be placed inside of a colored box so that it stands out more. Beamer automatically loads the AMS theorem environment, so we can use new theorem to create a theorem environment that will also behave like a block. We also have access to the proof environment as well, complete with its end of proof symbol. Up to this point, we've been using the default style, which is quite bland. There are both themes and color themes that you can use to make your presentation look better. There are 29 different themes and 19 different color themes that you can use. To use these, you can add one or both of these commands in the preamble. There is a website that shows you examples of every theme with every color theme so that you can explore your options quickly and easily. We have a short sampling here. For my class notes, I use the Boadilla theme with the default color theme because it's minimal without being as empty as the default. Most people stick with just the predefined themes and color themes, but there are deeper layers of customization if you want to go through the documentation to learn about it. At the bottom right of the Boadilla theme, you can see that there is a date and a page counter. There's actually a bit more that's happening here. In the preamble, we can set the title, author, and date, and if we do that, that information will populate the remaining boxes. That information will also feed into the make title command, which will make a title slide for your presentation. Different themes carry different pieces of information. We can see this if we use sections and subsections in our presentation. To see this more clearly, we will switch over to the Berlin theme. We can see the section labels across the top. Each subsection corresponds to a row of dots, and the number of dots is the number of frames in the subsection. These circles are clickable links, which can let you get to any page in the presentation easily. It's also possible to create a table of contents using the Table of Contents command. This has the added bonus of being able to highlight where you are in the presentation by adding in an optional parameter. If you use Current Section, it will highlight the current section and fade everything else. If you use Current Subsection, it will highlight just the subsection. This means that you can put the Table of Contents in lots of places in your presentation and use it to help your audience keep track of the big picture. As with everything else in LaTeX, you will really start to understand Beamer as you start to use it. I hope this video has given you a foundation that you can build on as you start to create presentations using Beamer.